Hello, hello guys. Here I have 3 mini computers, mini PC. All of them, they are not working, there's no power. Anyway, let me check. I have this one board here, one opened. I'm gonna return these 2 down. Okay, so far I haven't seen anything. But it's not turning on. Let me connect a charger. There is a charger. They use a 12 volt charger. Okay. Let's check. So let's start from the charger port. Where do we check? Let's check there. 41, 51, 41. Okay, it's jumping. Okay, the volts are jumping, as you can see. Okay, I believe there's a short. Then you can confirm, you can check the charger to confirm whether we have 12 volts or not. We do have 12 volts. Yeah, I hope you can see. And then from here, let's start. Okay, let me check the microscope. I think I'll need the microscope. Okay guys, let's continue. So what you do, you start the DC inject. Okay, anyway, let me try to understand something here. This is a 12 volts, right? So what you do here, you'll see there's a inside there's a pin there. I believe that pin is 12 volts. So what I'll do, you take your meter and then you turn it into continuity mode, and then from there you put your pin inside and then you check. I wanna check. Okay, this is ground. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, now we know. What do we know? Let's go back to a microscope. What do we know? We know that this pin here, is it this one here? And this one here, it's 12 volts. Now, we charge here, right? And then you check for continuity. It doesn't go here. What about here? Where does this go, right? I wanna see all of this. Okay, let's check here. Okay, this goes straight here. Okay, so this is our first fuse. After here, after the diode, it goes straight there. After there, it goes straight here. From this MOSFET, and then from this MOSFET, it goes where? On this resistor. And from this resistor. Okay, and then from this resistor, it goes straight. Okay, let me swipe. Okay, it goes here, right? Okay, from this resistor, straight from here, and then here as well. All right, so now what we do, let's check where the short starts. We connect one probe to ground, And then there. Okay, the short starts here. The ground is connected on top of the USB port. And then okay, here there is no short. Here there's no short, as you can see. The short starts after the first MOSFET, after this MOSFET. And then hold everything here is shorted to ground. Okay, the 12 volts is shorted to ground. So what I would like to do, let's try to detect a short, because I've been telling people that it's possible to detect a short, and there was a big debate on Facebook. People are calling me a scam, they're saying I'm lying by telling them that you can detect shorted capacitors, because I don't like injecting volts. I have my reasons why. I'm saying it's also not good. It's also not good. I don't recommend it. It's sharp, but but if you are good with motherboard, you can use my method, believe me, and it works fine. Okay, I'm gonna use my eyes then using a microscope to find the shot. Let's see. Okay, there we go. I found a shorted capacitor. And I know a lot of people will be saying, oh, why do you think, why you went straight to a capacitor? No, it's easy, because capacitors, they are responsible, they are more, it's more common when you are dealing with a short. It's normally a capacitor, cheap or fit, but in this case it's a capacitor. The immediate capacitor there is shorted. Some guys were gonna inject 12 volts, of which I don't recommend. You see, there's a short. This capacitor here is short. This one here is shorted. If you don't believe me, you'll see right now. And those guys who were shouting at me, saying I'm a scam or whatsoever, they should chill. I told the guy to chill and relax. I told him that if you've been working with board, you know that the common thing with capacitors, with shorted capacitors, is that they track. See, this cap here is tracked. But before even make wrong statements, let's see. Check that capacitor there. Let's check. That's it. So what I'm gonna do, let's check back thing. Let's remove that capacitor. And then check whether we will have a short or not. Hey Stello, I told some guys on Facebook that it is possible to detect a shorted capacitor. Give me the thing, the tweezers. I told them that you can spot a shorted capacitor without using without injecting power or without using special equipment. So they were lying, saying no, I'm lying, blah blah blah, I don't know how to use the multimeter. This guy, he was saying a lot of things, but here I just pointed the problem. This is the problem. But it's tracked. Let me see, capacitor is tracked. And now they're calling me a scam. They're saying I'm lying. No, no. No, I think now they are shocked, you see, because they've been using an old technique. And now they, you know, people resist change. Yeah, exactly. As soon as there's someone who's coming up with new theories, they resist. I repeat again, you can spot a shorted capacitor without injecting any power or using any thermal camera or whatsoever. You can spot them, you can see them. And you don't need a microscope, but just use my eyes. I think some they will even say, no, this guy, he used the thermal camera, or he injected power, and then he knew when they exited. Now he come back and point. No, I can't be doing that. I don't lie to myself. This is real, Baba. Yeah, but this guy doesn't know what come out. Why? This guy doesn't want to come out, guys. Why? Aibu. Okay, another thing. That's one more thing common about shorted capacity. Sometimes they even resist to come out of the boat. And I'm not lying, it's true, but they would say, no, that's a lie, blah, blah, blah. Hey, people lying, told them to chill, they should chill. I told them to breathe and then chill. And I'm busy. Okay, guys, now let's check this capacitor. Let's go ahead, let's check this cap. Yeah, boy! The multimeter is beeping. It's alright. See your cap there, see your capacitor there, see? Shorted. Okay. Now let's test this board. Let's see. Okay, let's see. Let's put back everything. Let's check. Aibo, wait. Let's go back there. This guy's wait. Let's check for a short there. But anyway, there's no short now. There's no short before. They even say I'm a skelem. Let's check there. See, there's no shots. Ha! I'm so happy. Okay, there's no shots. Alright, let's put back everything. Before they call me a scam, let's put back everything. I repeat again, you can spot shorted capacity. You don't need any special tools, unless if it's not tracked. Even if it's not tracked, I have some clues on how to spot a shorted capacity. Because I've been doing it. I even mentioned that lately, I made an example saying, if you take notes on my old videos, it's very rare to see me using a power supply. Normally I spot capacitors, and again I'm gonna tell you a trick on how to spot MOSFET. You can even spot MOSFET, guys. It's possible. No, you can spot MOSFET, but not to spot as such, but you can use your meter to. All right, I'm turning on. Okay, let's go. Where's the power button? Okay, let me connect a charger and then press the power button. Guys, do you think something else has bent? I'm pressing the power button. It's not turning on. Okay, you know what? Let's check the battery. I'm connecting a bit because I want to see something. I want to see if the machine will charge when the battery is connected or not. Oh, yeah, bro, there's a light. Okay, because this means it doesn't work if the battery is not connected. Okay, see there? There's a light. On. Okay, it turns on and then shut down. I don't know why. Okay, let's use a proper 12 volt. I believe my microscope it uses 12 volts. Let me try with my microscope. Okay, where's the power? Okay, yeah, there it is. We have a light. Okay, I think I know what is going on here. We need a proper 12 volt. So what I'm gonna do, let's do this. Okay, let's do this. Let's connect this 12 volt. After connecting this 12 volt, we'll have to okay, it's on. Now let's connect the power. I want to see if it will turn on or not. No, let's connect an HDMI, sorry. Okay, an HDMI is connected. Now let's check on the microscope. Okay, I'm gonna press the power button. there we go, there is loading Windows. yeah boo. Okay, anyway, I'm gonna close it before it shows the information here of which I don't want. And yeah guys, this is working sharp. Oh wait, you know what, I have a plan guys, I have a good plan. Let's call the owner together. Let's phone the owner, man.